Hello and welcome to the Unix Underground. I've got a very exciting tutorial for you today. What we're going to be taking a look at, it's a very phenomenal feature that's part of the 7.4 code release for the Cisco wireless LANs. And what I'm talking about is Cisco's Application Visibility Control, or AVC as it's commonly referred to. And what Cisco's Application Visibility Control allows you to do on your wireless LAN is not only see a very granular breakdown by client as to what traffic those clients are viewing, but it also allows you to do some congestion avoidance or some QoS, where we can actually use differentiated services code point markings on specific traffic. And then that traffic in the instance where you did have congestion on your production LAN would be given a higher priority than, let's say, your Facebook traffic or maybe your traffic from MySpace or some other sites that really aren't work related. And I'm going to walk through a series of examples today to show you how you can leverage in your enterprise wireless LAN Cisco's Application Visibility Control. So again, let's start out by taking a look here at the wireless LAN controller. For my demonstration, I'm using a Cisco 2504 wireless LAN controller, and this wireless LAN controller has three Cisco 3602i access points associated to it that we're using for our demonstration today. So again, the software version that you need to be running is at least, at a minimum, the 7.4 chain of code. And I'm actually running the latest version that's available today, and today it's Saturday, March 29th, and that's the 7.4.100.0 version of code on the Cisco wireless LAN controller. So the first thing I want to start out with is YouTube. Oftentimes you're going to have users who are roaming around your facility on your production wireless LAN, and they may be looking at YouTube videos, and they may be doing BitTorrent downloads, and these things can tend to be extremely bandwidth intensive. So as an administrator, you might want to either mark these at a very, very low DSCP value, or you may want to block these things altogether. So let's take a look here at the YouTube application, and you're looking at this is actually on an iPad 2 that is associated to the wireless LAN that we're currently using. And so I'm going to skip this ad here, but you can see we're not having much trouble surfing YouTube. I'm able to look at some goals, and let's take a look at some Barcelona goals here that are going to play in YouTube. I can actually switch from one video to the next video. We'll take a look at another Lionel Messi video here. Again, we've got an ad. So again, the key takeaway is here on this iPad right now on the wireless LAN, the production wireless LAN, I'm not having any issues at all surfing YouTube. So let me go ahead and close down the actual YouTube application, and I'll pull up VideoTube. And so again, here on VideoTube, you can see we've got some Cristiano Ronaldo footage. Again, high definition, very bandwidth intensive, and I'm downloading quite a bit of video footage off of YouTube. Okay, so the key takeaway here is that YouTube is working, and I'm able to do that on my mobile device. The next thing we want to take a look at is BitTorrent, and there are a number of reasons that you would want to stop BitTorrent traffic from being used on your network, both legal and productivity wise. So I'm using the uTorrent client, and you're looking at the desktop for my iMac, which does have a wireless connection on the production network. And so I'm going to come over here, we'll do add URL. I've already typed this in, and I'm going to click OK. And we're going to go ahead and we're going to confirm. We've already confirmed YouTube is working with two different YouTube applications on an iPad. Now we're going to go ahead and make sure that BitTorrent is working and that nothing's being blocked. And so you can see here it's actually taking a look, and there it goes, right? So there's my download speed, there's my upload speed for the information for this download, okay? And again, not having any problems at all with BitTorrent. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to stop this. I'm going to remove that download, and I'll actually quit out of the uTorrent client for just a second here. And now let's go ahead and address this. So how, as administrators or enforcers of policy, would we mitigate this type of traffic basically flooding our wireless LAN and monopolizing a lot of the bandwidth? So first we want to go to wireless, and it's under the wireless tab from the top that you'll see application visibility and control. If you click on application visibility and control, you'll see AVC profiles. So now you'll notice that I don't have any profiles created yet. So let's go ahead and click new, and we'll call this the ECC underscore prod underscore wireless LAN policy. And again, if you had a guest network or a guest SSID that was attached to a guest VLAN, then you would use this exact same area to create a policy for that VLAN or for that SSID, that wireless LAN. I'm going to click apply. And so here we are. We've created an AVC profile. I'm going to click on the profile, and that's going to take me into the rule creation area. So I'm going to add a new rule. And the first one I'm going to add is I want to address the BitTorrent issue right away. So we're going to say file sharing, BitTorrent, and drop. Now I could mark it with a DSCP value in the quality of service sense, but I'm going to drop this traffic. So we'll leave it as drop. I'll click apply. I'm going to add a new rule, and we're going to come down to voice and video, and I'm going to find YouTube. Right now you'll notice I went by a number of applications that run on wireless LANs that can be very bandwidth intensive. Netflix, Pandora, Rhapsody. So Cisco provides a very rich set of applications from which to choose to give you very granular control as to how that traffic is going to be handled. And the way that Cisco's doing this, the way the wireless LAN controller is doing this, is it is doing deep, intensive packet inspection, and it's looking at the heuristics of the data. So it's more than simply, hey, I know that BitTorrent runs on port X, and so we're going to take a look at port X. It's doing much more than that. And that's a huge advantage that the Cisco technology has over other technologies that are on the market today that are only interested in what port an application might be running over on your wireless LAN. So let's continue here. I'm going to come down here. I'm going to select YouTube. And we're going to drop that traffic as well. So I'll click apply. And then finally, we'll add one more rule. And this is, again, realistic scenario, WebEx meetings, right? So if you have employees who are trying to host WebEx meetings and they're contending for your wireless LAN network bandwidth with users who are doing BitTorrent downloads and users who are doing YouTube video surfing, you would want to make sure that the WebEx meetings take precedence. So we're actually going to go ahead and mark this. I want to make sure I show you an example of this. We could do Platinum Voice, which is the highest. You could do Gold Video, Silver, which is Best Effort, Bronze, which is Background, and then you could also do a custom DSCP marking. So I'm going to go ahead and leave it as Platinum Voice. And I believe that's a 46, there it is. All right, so I've basically created three very, very simple to follow rules here. The first one is if it's a BitTorrent client, any type of BitTorrent file sharing, that traffic will be dropped. If it's any kind of YouTube video, it's gonna be dropped. If it's a WebEx meeting, then we're actually gonna mark that with a DSCP value of 46, which is a platinum rating, which in the event that there was congestion here on this wireless LAN, that WebEx meeting traffic would be given priority. And a quick caveat here, I just want to make sure that I point out that what we're doing here with the application visibility control is not a replacement for a good firewall policy. You should always make sure that you have a good firewall policy in place. And these are also things, BitTorrent, YouTube, Facebook, that you might also want to be dropping at your firewall. But again, Cisco's application visibility control gives you the ability to accomplish that right here on the wireless LAN controller. And the second step of that is that it's going to allow us, and we're going to see it here in a second, it's going to allow me to take a look at all the traffic on a per client basis that a wireless device might be passing up and down on the wireless LAN infrastructure. Okay, so we've created our AVC profile, ECC prod wireless LAN policy. We've created three rules under that profile. We're dropping BitTorrent, we're dropping YouTube, and we're marking DSCP value 46 for any WebEx meetings because we want to make sure that takes priority. All right, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to click Save Configuration. Always want to save your configuration to make sure that you're keeping that information across reboots. Now, we've created the profile. We've created the profile. I've created the rules for the profile. So how do I apply this profile to my production wireless LAN? Well, I would want to come here to Wireless LANs. Reservoir Dogs is the production LAN. And underneath the QoS policy is where we would select. We want to enable application visibility on the Reservoir Dogs wireless LAN. And right here, AVC profile. It's currently set to none. And if we click the radio button, there's the policy that we just created, or the profile we just created, the ECC prod wireless LAN policy. All right, so I've selected that, and now I'm going to click apply. And it says changing wireless LAN parameters while it's enabled could cause a momentary drop. In some cases, this screen will go blank on you for 2 to 3 seconds, but then simply click on one of the tabs above, and there we go, and it's back. So clicking on the wireless LANs, and let's confirm that the application visibility control is enabled, and the application visibility control profile is the ECC prod wireless LAN policy. So now I'll come back over to my monitor screen. So what I want to do now is, let's pull BitTorrent back up with the uTorrent client. Here it is. And now I'm going to come in here, we're going to add a URL, and let's pick a different torrent. Let me go ahead and we'll use Richard Stallman in London, one of my favorite Linux contributors, founder of the GNU Foundation. Paste that in here. So I'll click OK, and we're going to go ahead and select OK. Now remember, we've just changed the wireless LAN policy so that anyone or any mobile device, and it, again, it could be a non-mobile device. This is an iMac that you're seeing the uTorrent client function on right now. But it's associated to our production wireless LAN. And as you can see, nothing is really happening here, right? This traffic is not being allowed to pass. I'll even do a force start. And as you can see, there's no upload speed, no download speed. Nothing is taking place for this torrent. Although it's clearly trying to communicate to start the download, it's not working. All right. So by simply enabling, and let's go back to wireless, application visibility and control, AVC profiles, and here is the ECC prod wireless LAN policy, there is our BitTorrent file sharing rule, and we're simply dropping that traffic. And as you can see, that traffic now is not being allowed to come on to our production wireless LAN. All right, let's move on to a true mobile device. This is an iPad 2 again, and we've got two YouTube applications. We have the YouTube app itself, and then we also have VideoTube, which can be used to surf YouTube as well. So let's take a look at the YouTube application. I'm gonna come down here to a Ronaldinho video. And let's see what happens now that we're trying to load this Ronaldinho video. Again, as you can see, it's just kind of spinning there. Nothing's really happening. And you may be asking yourself, well, maybe there's just some lag with this video. So let me select another video. I'll select the Lionel Messi Barcelona video. And again, as you can see, the video is just spinning. We're really not allowed to view anything on YouTube right now. Let's go up here to the very first one, Lionel Messi top 50 goals, right? And again, as you can see, the rule that we've added here back into the browser for YouTube voice and video to drop that traffic seems to be working, right? Okay, I'm going to close down the YouTube application. I'm going to load VideoTube, and we're not going to review that right now. Now we'll try to look at another Cristiano Ronaldo video. Again, just showing you that the deep packet inspection and the heuristics that are being looked at here, right? It's more than simply a port number. It's actually able to mitigate this YouTube traffic, and we're looking at two different applications that can be used to surf YouTube and to look at YouTube videos. And again, we're unable to see that video. Let me check on this video here. And you can even see on the right-hand side here where some of the thumbnails are having a challenge loading as well. We get a couple, but the thumbnails are also struggling to load. More importantly, this YouTube video is not being downloaded and it's not congesting your production wireless LAN, or it's not congesting your guest wireless LAN for that matter, if you didn't want to have YouTube on your guest wireless LAN. All right, so again, we take a look back here at the BitTorrent. We've successfully been able to mitigate individuals with mobile devices using BitTorrent. We've successfully been able to mitigate users using YouTube with mobile devices to surf YouTube videos. Now, what's interesting is we had a client that came to us and said, well, I've got users who are using their mobile devices to download BitTorrents, and they're very smart. We've blocked a number of TCP ports on the firewall, but they're able to change the TCP port and then circumvent the firewall rule that we've put in place. And this is really the strength of Cisco's application visibility control. And again, that deep packet inspection that's not tied to a TCP port, it's actually looking at the heuristics of the application to make its decision. So if you look at this uTorrent client, if I go to preferences, you can see where this is my incoming TCP port. If I click randomize now, and this is what our client was explaining to us, is that they've got users who are changing the port numbers. And as you see here, I have it set up to randomly change during launch. So right now we'll leave it at 61798. Right, as you can see, I'll click start. It's still unable to start. So maybe it's the port that's being blocked. Let's confirm that's not the case. I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna close down uTorrent. We'll say quit. I'm gonna come back down here. We're gonna start uTorrent back up. And remember, we'll start BitTorrent back up here. Remember we had 61798. Let's see what our port is now. All right, 13285. So as you can see, the port's randomly being changed, but does that help? Is that circumventing Cisco's application visibility control? And it clearly is not. The download is still not able to begin because that traffic is being dropped. And so let me even try the force start. And you can see, even with a force start, the traffic continues to be blocked. All right, so the next step, and one of the best features of all, is the ability to take a look at your clients by MAC address to see what those clients are looking at. And this is really one of the strengths of application visibility control. So 3 Charlie Echo Charlie, let's see what this guy's doing. You have the AVC statistics tab, and you can see here that that is definitely this iMac, that the MAC address that ends in 3 Charlie Echo Charlie is the MAC address for the iMac on which I'm doing this demonstration. And so you can see here that it is definitely trying to do some BitTorrent, and this is left over probably from when we were testing a little while ago, and there is a little communication traffic that goes back and forth. But as you can see, it's not downloading tons of BitTorrent. You can also see that there was some YouTube not too long ago, some ICMP, some Skype, DNS, Gmail, HTTP, and BitTorrent. All right, let's go back to the clients and let's take a look at the iPad. And the iPad is Charlie 5 Echo 5. And I know that because I checked it prior to setting up this lab. And you can see here, YouTube, right? It's been trying to use YouTube, but we've only gotten 464 bytes, right? So again, it allows you, the Cisco AVC control allows you to come in and take a look and see what your wireless clients are up to. What kind of data are they looking at? All right, the final step of this tutorial is going to be the deletion or the removal of the rules that we created earlier in order to demonstrate that once those rules have been removed, that order will, you know, everything will be returned to normal. So if management has made the decision that we want to go ahead and allow BitTorrent and we want to allow YouTube on our production wireless LAN, you would come into your AVC profiles, and this will also conclusively show you that it is working and currently blocking, because once I remove the BitTorrent and the YouTube rules from the ECC prod wireless LAN profile, that traffic is going to start up almost immediately. So I'll come back, I'm going to launch YouTube down in the iPad 2 window on the bottom left there, and the Lionel Messi top 50 goals, right? And you can see it's just sitting there and spinning because it's unable to download that information right now because it's being blocked on the production wireless LAN. So now I'm going to remove that rule. Are you sure you want to delete it? I'll say yes. And let's see what happens. If you notice, all of the thumbnails immediately filled in, right? And if you look over here on the left, we now have the Lionel Messi video beginning to download. And in fact, here I'll move to we'll go to a different video. And unfortunately, this one has an ad, but we'll get out of the ad here in a second. And if you remember, when we had the YouTube rule in place, not only did we not see the ad, we didn't see anything. Okay, and here it comes. All right, so there is your YouTube video. So again, BitTorrent still not working because we've got this rule here, although we've removed the YouTube rule, which has allowed us now to use our mobile device on the production wireless LAN, and we are now able to view YouTube videos. So as a final step, I'm going to remove the BitTorrent rule, right? And you can see I've removed the BitTorrent rule. I'll save my configuration to make sure that we keep our configuration. We have YouTube going, and I will now come up here, and you can see we had a forced download going. We don't have any speed showing yet, but I'm going to go ahead and click start. And now BitTorrent is going to attempt to download this file, and we should see right here in the speed columns, the download speed column and the upload speed column should populate when this download begins to start. And it's not coming down right now. Oh, there we go. Okay, fantastic. So as you can see, the BitTorrent download started as well. Took it a little longer, probably because it's from a far distance away. But there you have it. All right, so BitTorrent is now working and YouTube is now working. So as you can see, Cisco Application Visibility Control can be a very, very powerful tool. It can also be a tool that you use to really optimize and maximize your wireless LAN traffic, especially if it's traffic that's traveling across your production wireless LAN. Okay, that's all I've got for this tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed it. Again, a very, very dynamic and rich set of features that are part of software release 7.4 on the Cisco wireless LAN controllers. I hope that you get some use out of this. I hope at some point you get an opportunity to work on a Cisco wireless LAN where you have the ability to use the application visibility control. This is Travis from the Unix Underground. Thanks for watching and have a great day.